is James Holder for IFL TV in association with Macklin's Gym, Marbella. With me, I've got Anthony Bellew. What's happening, Anthony? You okay?
I am fine, thanks, James.
That's what I like to hear. Fifth round stoppage for you today.
Yeah.
Good win. Never really in danger, but you still dealt with what was in front of you the way in professional manner.
Yeah.
Talk to me through the fight a little bit.
Yeah, I just got in, mate. I got the rounds in. I enjoyed, you know, trying to figure the southpaw puzzle that was in front of me. It's important at this stage in my career to get rounds and ultimately dispatch of them kind of fighters. Mm-hmm. It's very rare that he gets stopped. I think stopped two or three times genuinely in 40-odd fights. So it's nice to get a stoppage win. But the most important thing is to show that, you know, I wasn't really struggling too much with the southpaw style and that I got the job done, mate. So, you know, on to the next one and hopefully it's the big one.
I mean, just talking on today's fight, he didn't seem to want any of them left hands. When the left hands were connecting the power, he probably could have got out of there a lot earlier than what the referee took him out.
Do you think that's a fair assessment? He was very, very brave, very, very tough, but you'd expect nothing less. You know, these Eastern European guys, Latvia, Georgia, very, very tough men, hard men, you know, the fighting's in the blood. And he was no different tonight. He gave me a few smirks. Hit me low a couple of times. I think it was just to catch a little breathers in there. But listen, this is professional boxing. It's not a game of tiddlywinks, is it? So
the head
it
clash.
Is what it is.
When you clashed heads, he sort of went to say sorry to you, and you punched him in the face. I thought that was quite.
Yeah, listen. Quite like nice. I say, this is professional boxing, and we're not here to play games. I'm not here to be friends. I'm here to hit you as fast and as much as possible. Whatever it takes to stop a man in his tracks, I'll do so. No, nice guy, but ultimately, you know, nice guy comes last. And as he's trying to be nice after they headbutt me, I'm not wanting to be nice back. Like I say, it's rough, it's a brutal business, and I've learned that the hard way through experience.
Juan Pablo Hernandez versus Ramirez has been put back yet again.
Yes.
Was that disappointing for you to hear that news?
I was kind of anticipating it and expecting it, to be honest. It now goes to October the 2nd in Argentina. Listen, my career is not based around Victor Ramirez or Juan Pablo Hernandez. My career is based around me. I genuinely create interest in me through what I do, through what I say, through the way I fight. And it is what it is, mate. People tune in. I don't know whether they're tuning because they want to see me get my head knocked off, or whether they're tuning because they actually like me. I don't know, but and I'm sure that will go to another level this year as well with what's coming in the future. So we'll see. You know, time will tell how my path unfolds. I still believe 100% genuinely believe there is a world title in that path without a shadow of a doubt. It's only a matter of time till I get my hands on one. And when I do get my hands on one, that's when I truly believe that my path will really unfold and that we will see the very, very best of me.
Who would you rather fight between Juan Pablo Hernandez and Ramirez if you had a choice?
You know, I'll be totally honest. Hernandez is the ring and the linear champion of the division. In all honesty, I just want to fight the best fighter in this division. Because when I win a world title, I want to sit there and genuinely say with my hand on my heart, I am the best cruiserweight in the world. And I believe by beating, if it's me who beats Hernandez or whoever beats Hernandez and I have to beat that guy, that's who I believe can genuinely stand in and call themselves the best cruiserweight in the world. Because for me, Juan Pablo Hernandez right now is the best cruiserweight in the world. No two ways about it. He's the hardest to beat. Stylistically, technically, he's the best. A 6'4" Cuban southpaw doesn't get any worse. Can punch a little bit, can move, has all the tools. So stylistically, and technically, he is the best fighter in the division. And he has proven that time and time again. I thought Hook was a close second. But after what's happened with him recently, you know, it seems that just isn't the case. And there's actually fighters probably above maybe Hook now even.
Did it sort of, not get you down, but sort of frustrating that you didn't get a chance to fight Hook before he lost?
No, because he makes ridiculous demands. And, you know, like I said, I'm not going to Germany because I've seen what happens to people in Germany, you know. We've all seen it before, so I don't want to be a victim of that kind of crime that goes on in Germany sometimes. I've also seen good decisions in Germany. Listen, everywhere has good and bad decisions, but there just seems to be a few more highlighted ones in Germany. It is what it is, mate. I just want to become world champion, and I want to do that by fighting the best guy. If the best guy was Marco Hook, then so be it, but he is not no longer, and he has just been stopped. So, listen, time will tell. The paths will all unfold in front of your eyes. you know, for yourselves to see. And Glowacki's now injured, needs surgery. We have Gregory Zod from Russia, Denis Lebedev from Russia, myself. So it's there's options everywhere. I've had offers from everyone. I've had offers from Heyman, for Shumanov, for Flores, for other cruiserweights in America, and now I have had offers from Russia for Lebedev and Zod. So ultimately, I must be doing something right.
Who do you think is the best out of Lebedev and Zod?
I think Lebedev's tougher. I think Zod's technically better. I like Zod, the look of him. Technically very good. Little bit robotic, but strong, fit, game. Come back great from the loss against Firat Aslan. Lebedev is a tough soldier. He is what he is. You know what you're going to get. Southpaw, walks forward, likes to fight, fights with his face. Heart of a lion. Very, very strong, but very, very limited. I think he may be the easiest technically to beat, but he might just be the toughest out the whole lot. So it's crazy. They've all got the strengths and weaknesses. I think the only one who doesn't have real big weaknesses is Hernandez. There's no real flaws to his game.
As you said, how do you prepare for a 6'4" southpaw from Cuba?
You just don't. You just hope for the best. No, it's tough. It really is. I'm going to have to get in the best of sparring. I really don't know. But if it's him, then it is what it is. Listen, I'm making no, you know, qualms about it. I don't like fighting southpaws, but ultimately, it just happens. You know, the biggest fight in my life came against one of them. You've just got to deal with it when it comes. You've got to take the opportunities that are given to you. And, you know, what can I do? If the best fight, I've just got to get in with them and try my best to beat them. So it is what it is. You've just got to get on with it, mate.